Greetings from EA Sports. I'm Brad Nessler, and alongside me are Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit. This is going to be very unpleasant cold weather for these boys to battle as we get ready for the Penn State Nittany Lions and the Pittsburgh Panthers. We hope you're ready for an action-packed game of NCAA football. And here come the Panthers. The Nittany Lions don't seem to match up too well in this one. Kirk, I'm not sure I like their chances very much.
Pittsburgh looks a little overpowering in this one. I think it's all because of their running back. He's a tremendous athlete. And Lee, I think he'll have a big game running behind those big hog mollies up front.
I guess I should let you in on my pick then.
Look out. I'm going with Penn State.
Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He sends it downfield. Number 42 takes it to 25. Now we'll get to see how this quarterback can do today as he comes out onto the field for the first time. Well, guys, how do you think this rushing attack is going to do against this defense today?
I know that this offense has a wonderful running back, but not so fast, my friend. I think this defense is going to win the battle today, led by a superstar linebacker.
Yeah, this linebacker should have a big impact on this game. If he plays well, the defense will hold up. But if he plays bad, he may be in for a long day.
It's second down now and 13 to go. Ball on the 36. Number 33 is a deep back. They line up in the eye. Tackle made at the 38. A 2-yard run by the halfback. They line up at the 38. Here's third and 11. They line up in an eye, looking to throw. He's taken off. They'll bring him down at the 41. 3 yards there on the quarterback keeper.
Fourth and eight.
The Panthers line up to punt. Number 19 is the deep man awaiting the return. He gets it off. Signals for a fair catch. Well, the offense will come out and see if they can't get an early lead on their first drive. The offense will start at the 17-yard line. Penn State lines up with three receivers. They'll get him for a loss. Second down.
Ball on the 16-yard line.
They line up in the shotgun. He tackles him for a loss. Nice tackle to bring him down before he got back to the line of scrimmage.
Solid effort there to break up that play.
Third and 13. Penn State lines up in a shotgun set. Drops back to pass. He's looking. Throws. Has it to the senior. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Number 39 will be the return man. He gets it away. Number 39 signals for a fair catch.
Yo, the defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive.
Yeah, the offense wasn't clicking on their last possession. We'll see if they have things figured out on this next drive.
They'll take over at midfield. The Panthers set up in the gun. There's a play fake. Surveys the field. Airing it out long. It falls incomplete. Number 29 was the intended target on the play. That'll bring up second down. It's second and 10. Ball on the 50. Pittsburgh comes out in the shotgun. And he's taken down at the 48-yard line. Third and 8. Ball right around midfield. Pittsburgh comes to the line with three wide. Looks. He lets it go. And it falls incomplete. The quarterback aired it out, but too far.
Yeah, great try by the receiver. Technically, he caught the pass, but he won't get credit for the catch because he was out of bounds.
The Panthers line up to punt. Number 41 is waiting for the snap. He punts this one high in the air. Signals for a fair catch. So the offense takes over, and the last time they had the ball, they had a tough time getting anything going. The offense will take over at the 15. First and 10. Little misdirection. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. 2 yard loss for the halfback. Second down and 12. Ball on the 13 yard line. Penn State lines up in a shotgun set. For a loss. Third and 13. They line up in the shotgun. He lets it go, and that one's incomplete. That brings up a punting situation.
I'll tell you what, this defense did a heck of a job that time to hold them to three and out.
The punter comes on the field, getting ready to send one off. Number 39 is back to receive. Number 11 punts it, and he didn't get much distance on it. Signals for a fair catch. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
The offense looked a bit out of sync on that last possession, Coach.
And it was the defense that threw him out of sync, Kirk. Those guys are fired up. Let's see if they can hold them again.
We've got a first and 10. Number 12 with three wide receivers. Throws it to the outside. Almost intercepted.
How about that defense?
Well, that's why he's on the field, to make plays like that.
So that'll make it second down. Second down and 10 to go. 41-yard line. They come out in a nickel, drop back to pass, across the middle, and they make the stop at the 28-yard line.
Move the chain gang, because they just got themselves a first down.
Yeah, the quarterback and receiver were on the same page on that pass.
It's first and 10, ball on the 28-yard line. Number 12 comes to the line with three wide, gives it up the gut. And he's tackled at the 25. Number 33 gains around 3 yards on the run. So that'll make it second down. Second down and 7. Ball on the 25. Pittsburgh sets up in the eye. Looks to pass. Looks. He delivers. And it's intercepted. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 15-yard line. The Nittany Lions come out in the ace formation. Look at the throw. Looking, he passes it. And it's incomplete. Number 89 was the intended receiver on the play. So that'll make it second down. From their own 15-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. The Nittany Lions are lining up with three receivers. Handoff. Tackle made at the 22-yard line. A 7-yard run by the running back. From their own 22-yard line, it's third down. The Nittany Lions line up with a single set backfield. And down he goes at the 26. And he gets the first down.
That guy just went pow and took it in. He wasn't stopping until he got that first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26. That's the end of the first quarter, folks. No score after one. First down, the Nittany Lions set up in the gun. Rifles it over the middle. It's tipped. Nice job knocking that one down.
You're right. Good job there on the coverage. That's just what they teach you to do.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 26. The Nittany Lions line up with three wide. There's a play fake. Throws to the middle, and it's the senior. And that tackle's going to save them six. Nice little pitch and catch with a wideout.
Quarterback and receiver spend a lot of time together. The coaches say they stay after practice, just working on their timing right there and paying off.
It's first and 10, ball on the 50. Penn State comes out with an I formation. Tosses left, and he's taken down at the 45. 5-yard gain on the toss play. They line up at the 45. We've got a second and 5. They're in the eye. Brought down at the 41-yard line. About 4 yards on the counter to the halfback. Third and 1 coming up on this play. Ball on the 41-yard line. Touch to the right. Can he get to the sticks? He's tackled at the 41. Not much for the runner as he gets back to the line of scrimmage. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They line up in an eye. Fakes to the back. Swatted away. Well, they'll turn it over on downs. Did they have to go for it there?
Well, sometimes you got to take your chances. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose.
First and 10. Ball on their own 41.
First and
10. Tries to juke. And he couldn't go anywhere on that run.
Nah, he couldn't go anywhere because there was no place for him to run. The defensive front got a good push and knocked that offensive line backwards.
They line up at the 41. Second down. They come out in a nickel. They hand it off again. And down he goes at the 44. Number 33 gains around 3 yards on the run. That'll make it third down. Third down and 7. Ball on the 44-yard line. The Panthers are lining up with three receivers. He looks. He unloads it. And that one's fallen incomplete. Number 29 was the intended receiver on that pass. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team. Pittsburgh lining up the punt. Number 19 is the deep man awaiting the return. Punts the ball away. Number 19 fields it at the 19. I don't think we'll see this offense get into a similar situation this time.
So you think they'll convert on fourth down if they go for it again?
Hey, why not? If you're having to go for it on fourth down a lot, you're not doing so hot, sweetheart.
They'll go to work at the 19. Penn State lines up with three receivers. He jukes it. Number 14 with a fumble. Number 85 scoops up the fumble. The linebacker made a heads-up play to recover that fumble.
Boy, I'll say he did. He knew right where to be.
Excellent field position to start the drive. Pittsburgh comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Which is right. Missed tackle. And they make the stop at the 16-yard line. That's 4 yards on the play. It's second down and six to go. Ball on the 16. Tackled at the 9-yard line. So he got a few yards on that carry.
You know what, guys? If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Pittsburgh just took their first time out. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Pittsburgh lines up in a shotgun set. Number 19 with a fumble. Number 53 recovers a loose ball. What happened there, coach?
Let me tell you what. The wideout wasn't carrying the ball like he should. And the defender made a nice play to jar it loose.
They'll get the ball here at the 14. The Panthers bring in their dime package. That's incomplete. Number 86 was the intended target. That'll bring up second down. Second and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Penn State lines up in a double tight set. Play fake. They'll make the sack. The Panthers call a timeout, and they'll have one timeout left. Third and about 15 yards to the sticks. Ball on their own 9. Penn State lines up in a goal line set. A little handoff. A little juke. At the 30. At the 40. Across midfield. At the 40. At the 30. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 21. And he breaks one on third down.
Boy, that was a good play call by the old head coach right there.
Good call. Great execution. And again, we've seen this before, and the result is a big third down run.
First and 10.
Ball on the 21.
Penn State comes out in the shotgun. He'll dump this one off. Shakes off a tackle. And he's taken down at the 11-yard line. Penn State will take a timeout. And that was their first timeout. From the 11-yard line. Second down and short. He'll get it again. Tackle made at the 8. Penn State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. It's first and goal. They're threatening inside the 20. Number 42 is the single setback. Feeds it to the back. He's hit and got away. Well-designed play to get the halfback into the end zone.
Hey, for this guy, it doesn't matter how it's drawn up. He can make his own play as he goes along. Nice run.
They'll line up for the point after. He makes the PAT. So with just over a minute to go in the half, the score, Penn State 7, Pittsburgh nothing. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And this one's away. Number 24 fields it at the 18. I'm sure the defense will be trying to strip the ball once again.
And if these kids don't start hanging on to the football, they won't see another offensive series. They might start putting in some of those defensive players that really want to play bad.
Pittsburgh trying to put a drive together here to tie it up before halftime. Play action. He throws left. And it's incomplete. The quarterback saw the blitz and let it fly, but too high.
Oh, that rhymes.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. They come out with three wide receivers. Drops back to pass. Let's it go. His back makes the catch. Tackle at the 40-yard line. How about that pass, fellas?
Well, Brad, the defense was coming with the blitz, and that opened some room for these guys to get open.
Yeah, and if you're coming with the blitz, you better get to this quarterback. Otherwise, he'll make you pay.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40. They line up in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. And here's a quick throw. He's tackled at the 35. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
It's second and 5 here. Number 22 is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Sack for a loss at the 40. They'll go with a no huddle. The Panthers go with the I formation. Got hit as he threw. The Panthers line up to punt. Number 41 awaits the snap. Number 41 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Calls for the fair catch. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown. This drive will start at the 13-yard line. First and 10. They'll work from the shotgun. Give to the tailback. Juke move. And they make the stop at the 16-yard line.
That run just put him over 100 yards, and we're still in the first half.
We have a long way to go in this game, Kirk. This kid has potential to finish this game with a heck of a lot of yards.
Yep, and if this offensive line continues to block the way that they've been blocking, then there won't be anybody stopping him.
High formation here. Inside handoff. Make the move. They'll bring him down at the 17. And we've reached halftime here. The score at the break, Penn State 7, Pittsburgh nothing. We're ready to start the second half as the teams are lined up for the kickoff. And this one's a short kick. Number 32 takes it to 15. Missed tackle. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. The offense will start at the 34-yard line. Penn State lines up with three receivers. Here's the halfback. Broke away from one. And he's tackled at the 40. The running back gives him six on the ground. They line up at the 40. It's second down. That was well defended by this defense.
Hey, that linebacker made a nice play. But what about all those big guys up front on the defensive line? They're good too, boy.
Well, they created the play this time, Coach. The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
The Nittany Lions come out in the ace formation. Over the middle. It's deflected. Number 86 was the intended receiver on the play. And that'll bring up a punting situation. It's away, short punt. Number 39 fields it to 31. And now we'll see the offense come out of the field for their next possession. They'll go to work at the 32-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. Breaks one. Look at the power. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. So they get the first down, but not by much.
Well, I think they're happy with the first down after he almost got stuffed in the backfield.
Well, this kid showed great strength on that play to shed the tackle and make the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 43. Pittsburgh lines up in a double tight set. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Number 33 comes away with 2 yards on the carry. Second down, 8 yards to go. Number 33 is the single setback. They'll get him for a loss. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
Great penetration in the backfield. For such a big guy, this guy's got some really quick feet.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
He drops back. He darts it over the middle. And he's got him on a streak. He's all the way down to the 27-yard line. Excellent recognition by the quarterback to pick up the blitz and get the ball off in time.
On the next level, one of the things you've got to be able to do is read when the blitz is coming. That play shows that he's on his way of being ready for the big leagues.
First and 10.
Ball on the 27-yard line.
Pittsburgh comes to the line with three wide. And he's stopped behind the line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 28. Pittsburgh goes with the ace set here. Tackle at the 12-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
Great blocking and great running equals very successful offense.
And they've looked really good on this drive, Coach. The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
They're inside the 20. They're in the red zone after coughing up the ball on their last trip down here. He didn't get much on that play at all.
Brad, the defense had that play read and sealed it off from the get-go.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 13-yard line. Pittsburgh lines up in a double tight set. Inside handoff. Tackle made at the 6. Number 33 gets 7 yards on the play. The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. He drops back. Across the middle. Touchdown, Pitt! That was a sharp pass that found the wide receiver for a score.
This kid is going to do some damage. His pocket presence is exceptional. He's got a good arm.
What I'm impressed with is the guy's decision making.
Will be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Just over a minute to go here in the third quarter. And the score, Pittsburgh 7, Penn State 7. They line up to kick this one away. And it's a short kickoff. Number 32 takes it at the 14. Well, the offense couldn't get anything going on their last drive. Let's see if they can do a little bit better here. The offense will take over at the 30-yard line. Penn State comes to the line with three wide. Bounces off a would-be tackler. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
Gain of 4 on the play.
They line up at the 34. Second down. Penn State lines up with three receivers. They'll give it off here. Brought down at the 36-yard line. Number 42 comes away with 2 yards on the carry. Third down and 4 coming up on this one. Ball on the 36-yard line. Penn State lines up in a shotgun set. Again with the run. They'll get him for a loss. And that brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
Right. Fourth and seven.
The punter comes on the field, getting ready to send one off. Number 39 is back awaiting the punt. He punts it. Number 39 fields it at the 35. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for six.
A great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
First down.
Start the drive at the 42-yard line. First and 10.
The Panthers go with the I formation. You move. He's tackled at the 45. Number 33 gains around 3 yards on the run. And so we've reached the end of quarter number three here. With one quarter to go, we're all tied up. They line up at the 45. It's second down and seven to go. Pittsburgh comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Tries to juke. Tackle at the 50. 4, maybe 5 yards on the run. Third down and two to go. They line up at the 50. Pittsburgh comes out with two tight ends. It's the tailback. He's taken down at the 48. He didn't get much, but he got enough for the first down.
Well, that's really all they wanted there, was to pick up the first down and get a fresh set of downs and continue to move the ball downfield.
First and 10. Ball on the 48. Pittsburgh comes out with an I formation. Moves up in the pocket. Throws it. He's got the fullback. And they push him out at the 39. How about that pass, Kirk?
You know, guys, one of the things often overlooked in college football is the relationship between a quarterback and his receiver. Here, you can see that these two are definitely on the same page.
Second and short. Ball on the 39.
39-yard line.
Ace backfield. Let's it fly. Incomplete pass. Number seven was the intended target, so that'll make it third down. The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. Sweep left. Sheds that one. The 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. Great looking play by the offense as the halfback took it in for the score.
Here's a play that was well designed and well executed. Can't get much better than that.
They'll line up for the point after. He makes the PAT. So with just over 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Pittsburgh 14, Penn State 7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Short kickoff. Number 89 takes it at the 16. Guys, what are you thinking at this point in the game?
Well, they have a little bit of time, but I think it's very crucial that they get the ball in the end zone on this possession.
I agree with you, Kirk. They can take their time, but a field goal is just about out of the question.
They'll start this drive at the 30. Penn State comes to the line with three wide. Looks. Somehow gets the ball away. Incomplete.
That's what a good pass rush can do for you.
Yep, they got in the quarterback's face and made it tough on him to throw a good pass.
Second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Ball on the 30-yard line.
batter in the eye. Handoff on the draw. Brought down at the 35. The halfback gets the call and picks up five. It's third down. Number 14, the three wide receivers. He's looking to pass. They can't connect. Incomplete. Pressure that time, and he was forced into throwing before he wanted to.
Wow, the kid just avoided getting smacked on that one.
The punter comes on the field, getting ready to send one off. Number 39, the return man. He gets it off. Number 39 fields it for 31. That last drive resulted in a touchdown. They did a great job moving the ball on the ground. Let's see what they can do here. You better believe they're going to be working that clock on this drive. The Panthers come out in a two tight end set. On the ground, right side. He's tackled at the 37-yard line. Number 33 comes away with 5 yards on the carry. That'll bring up second down. It's second and five here. Ball on their own 37. Pittsburgh comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. And they make the stop at the 47. He seems to be running harder and harder as the game goes along.
And if you notice, guys, the defense seems to be getting a little bit tired out there.
It's first and 10, ball on the 47-yard line. Pittsburgh sets up in the eye, hands it off, makes a move. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. Number 33 gains about 2 yards on the run, so that'll make it second down. From their own 49-yard line, it's second down. The Panthers line up with a single set backfield. Tries to juke, and he's taken down at the 43-yard line. Number 33 gets 8 yards on the play. They line up at the 43. It's third down and short. They come out in a goal line set. Toss to the right. Can he get to the sticks? First down. Pittsburgh comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. And he tackles him hard at the 45. Penn State will take their first time out of the half. So it's second and 12. Ball on the 45-yard line. Pittsburgh lines up with three receivers. Taken down at the 43. Penn State calls a timeout. That was their second timeout. So another third down upcoming for the offense. The Panthers are lining up with three receivers. He's looking for his man. Caught. Nice play call to get him the conversion.
When a team converts on third down, they can really frustrate a defense. When they convert a third and long, it just makes them sick.
They'll line up at the 25. First down. Up the middle with a fullback. Brought down at the 24-yard line. The fullback rumbles ahead for about a yard. Great. Here's play number 10 on the drive. The Panthers line up in a goal line formation. He's tackled at the 23, and he gets a yard on the run. Penn State will take their final timeout. Congratulations to our players of the game. Both of these young men should hold their heads up high today. Pittsburgh comes out with an I formation. They'll go with a run once again. They'll bring him down at the 18. They get about 5 yards from the halfback. And we take a quick look at the stats from inside the 20-yard line. Brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone. Experience is everything. Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown. I don't expect this one to be any different. And it splits the uprights. Is lining up to kick this one off. Number 32 and number 89 back ready to return. Here's the kick. Number 32 fields it at the 11. He's hit and got away. Guys, what are you thinking at this point in the game?
There is just too much ground to make up and not enough time, Coach.
Yep, they played very well today, Kirk. This game is a lot closer than the score on the scoreboard is showing right now.
They'll go to work at the 32. Number 14 lines up in the shotgun. Drops back on first down. He throws it. This one is incomplete.
That's going to go down as a drop, my friend.
A very frustrating drop. I like the play call. I like the pass even more, but it really doesn't matter if the receiver can't bring it in.
From their own 32-yard line. So it's second and 10. Number 14 back in the gun. Looking to throw. He throws. He's taken down at the 50-yard line.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
Looks to pass. He throws it, and this one falls incomplete. Number 81 was the intended receiver on the play, so that'll make it second down. Second down. The Nittany Lions come out in the ace formation. Complete, and he's tackled in the open field. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Penn State lines up with three receivers. He throws right, and it falls incomplete. It's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They're crowding the line. The halfback with a carry. They bust up the play and stop them on fourth down. Well, they had to go for it, but they don't make it.
Yeah, but I like the call. They needed to do whatever they could to get back in this ballgame.
Too bad it didn't work out the way they wanted it to.
And that's the end of the ball game. Kirk, what did you think of this one?
You know, I think it was a well-played game for the most part. Penn State probably feels they should have won this game, but they just didn't make enough big plays when they needed to.
Folks, thanks for tuning into our game. Our final score, Pittsburgh 17, Penn State 7.